Good evening everyone. So in this video we are going to discuss about keys and couplings over both the things. It will becomes in the part B of the computer aided machine drawing subject. Okay, so first we are going to discuss about the keys. So normally the keys, it may be the commonly it will be employed connect the shaft and a part of drive in the small piece of a metal. It is known as the keys over here. So normally the power will be going to be transmitted from the prime mover into the some of the device. So those devices which can be connected with the coupler. The coupler it will be going to connect the shaft permanently with the help of the this keys over there. So in this video we are going to discuss about keys like a parallel key, like a tap sunk key, a gibbet key, and a wood roof key. So these are all the things we are going to discuss over here. Afterwards we are going to discuss about the coupling. So normally in the keys, so it will be a feather parallel key means both the side having the same length. Okay, thickness will be remain same from this end to this end. So from year to year we are going to calculate width, and from year to year the thickness, this will be the length. Okay, so the length, the thickness is going to measure with the help of the 0.5t plus 0.1 mm. okay, so with the help of those formula we are going to calculate this feather and parallel keys. So normally along that thickness they are going to give. So with the help of the thickness, the other values we are going to find over there. Okay, so this is the pi d over there about the parallel. So here the value they are going to relate with the diameter, not the thickness. So width of the key going to find with the help of the formula is called it as 0.25d plus 2 mm. okay, so with the help of that the width of the key is going to calculate it over there. Okay, the length they are going to give over here. This is about the parallel key. Then comes into the sunk key. So in the sunk key, the shape of that is key is in the parallel manner. So this is also called a taper sunk key. So here they are going to maintain the taper is the 1:100. So here there are two types of taper sunk key is there. So one will be a flat edge, another will be the round edge of the end surfaces. Like this two things are available. So here width of the key, okay, width of the key is going to maintain with the help of this formula, like a 0.25d plus 2 mm, and nominal thickness is 0.66 w. so it will be remain same for both the parallel keys as well as taper sunk key. The standard taper is the 1:100. Okay, so this is the point we have to remember over here. That small cutout where the this thing will be accommodated over in the shaft as well as in the coupler. Okay, so that thickness is the 0.5 t. okay, so here also 0.5 t, it will be going to make the groove even in the coupler also 0.5 t, shaft also 0.5 t we are going to cut. And this one also 0.5 t we are going to cut over here. Okay, so this is about the taper sunk key. Then comes into the gibbet key. So here in the gibbet key, one more the head is going to be placed over here. So that is, we can call it as height. Okay, so here also we are going to maintain the thickness as 1:100 and width of the key is normal same like 0.25 d plus 2 mm, and nominal thickness is 0.66 d, taper is the 1:100, and also height of the gibbet key is the 1.75 t, that is the from ear to height 1.75 t. width of the kib bed is the 1.5 t. so this is the width of the kib bed 1.5 t. okay, so this is about the one. So here the angle, thread chamfer angle, they are going to maintain 45 degree from the thickness. Okay, so from this and this, it will be remains same height. Okay, so normally this will be coupled shaft as well as this one coupler, like in this manner. So this is the thing we are going to design over here. This is the 0.5 d. so here we have to maintain this distance. So the length of the key they are provided, according to that we are going to make this groove over there. Okay, so if you are fitting this rivet key, normally it will strongly it will be fitted into the shaft and the coupler, so that power transmission is going to be easily takes place. Okay, so suppose it will not fit as per the tight, the acceleration it will be takes place. Suppose it will be going to fit in the tight fit, means while rotating it will require more energy, so that the correct fit it has to be fit over here. Okay, so this is about that. All those things we have to remember over the formula. So Woodruff key, so in the Woodruff key the 3D picture it will be like this. So here this is the width and this will be the length of the Woodruff key. So height is this much, so almost it will be like a semicircular in shape. So width of the key here is the 0.25 d. so this will be the 0.25 d. diameter of the key is the 4w, so 4 times into the width of the key, and height of the key is the 1.75 d. so here the width of the key, normally it will be placed on the some taper in shapes in the components, like this it comes. So this is the views of the Woodruff key. According to this formula we are going to design, and we can keep over this Woodruff key. Okay, so the diameter they are providing over here. So this is about the keys. Now we are going to move on to the couplings. So normally the couplings which can be going to connect the two shaft. Okay, so normally we people know that with the help of the motor the power power is created, so that has to be transmitted via the shafts over here. Okay, normally the maximum length of the shaft is the 6 meter, so we are going to carry out the power from more than 6 meter, means some 2 shafts are going to connect over there. Okay, while connecting the shafts it requires some intermediate, that is that intermediate device is the coupling. Okay, the coupling is a device which can be going to connect the two shafts rigidly over there. So for that the coupling will be used over there. Okay, so in the coupling it has to be normally there are several types: pin type, flexible coupling, and universal coupling. So and the flanger coupling, split muff coupling, and all. Okay, old arms coupling and all. So here the flanger coupling and other thing I done the 3D modeling over in the software. Okay, so those video I uploaded in the Google Classroom. So please verify in the same manner we are going to do in the coupling we are going to discuss now over here. So here the diameter shaft is the they are providing. So from that this diameter of the shaft, according to that this coupling diameter they are going to calculate with help of 1.5 d plus 0.25. so the maximum diameter of these things, so like here they are providing, so like the height. Okay, so from those values okay, So that is the 2.5D plus 75. Okay, so like each and everything that net that will become 0.8D. So all those value can go into calculate it. So from this particular length of this component, it is the D, even here also D. So the maximum this one will be the 1.25 D plus 20 over here. Okay, so the maximum length from here to here, like 1.25 D plus 20 into twice. Okay, so that is the thing. So with the help of this formula, we are going to construct over there. So almost this type of power drawing they are providing. So according to that, we can going to make the pin type flexible coupling over in the software, like in the 2D manner. In the 2D manner, we have to create in the drawing mode. Okay, we should not go with the solid mode. So these things we are going to make with the solid mode. So here they are showing us the off-sectional front view. So only in the top they are making sectional one, and the bottom they are going to normal front view. So here what happens, to showing the inside the screw, nut and bolt screws. Why? Because of these things, it is going to be rigidly fixed over the two shafts. So here the two shafts will be going to be connect over there. Okay, so the gap exists between here is the 0.1D. So the gap exists between two shafts, they are going to keep the 0.1D. So here they are providing some keys. Okay, so like whatever is discussed over the parallel key, sunket key, all those keys, like they are going to be inserted. So tightly fix the coupling and as well as this shaft, the keys will be used over here. So according to this dimension, we are going to create the flexible coupling. So in this diagram, they are showing us the universal coupling. So the universal coupling, it will be like this. So this is the shaft, this is the key diameter, the fork, and here the collar. Okay, so the taper pin has provided for the universal coupling. This is the center block, this is the pin, one more shaft is connected over here. Okay, so this is about the universal coupling. So same like it has to be fixed, here the shaft, one more shaft over here, key is provided over here. Okay, the key to rigidly fix and both coupling device as well as the shaft. To transmit the one, it will be helps, and the diameter of that this one, like universal coupling one here, that is the 1.8D, and the distance from here to here 2.4D. like this taper collar diameter is that D, and inside this will be the 0.60. like all those value we have to remember, all those value we have to buy up, and we can apply into that. Finally, we are going to get over there. Okay, so the length of the this one from there to collar, like 2.60. so the diameter up to 1.1D for the universal coupling over there. Okay, so these are all the values we have to remember. Then we have to make this universal coupling. So in the 2D manner, the front view and side view are going to make over there. So in this universal coupling, what happens, the shaft, one shaft is connected over here, another shaft is rigidly fixed over here. Okay, so these are all the supporting device will be going to support the two shafts over here. But in the previous one, they are going to give the gap between the two shafts is the 0.1D, but it will be exist the more gap over from here to here. Okay, almost 1.3D, 2.6D, the gap it may be exist over between the two shafts over here. So this is about the universal coupling. The universal coupling, the component name they are providing, like a fork, center shaft, parallel key, pin, collar, taper pin, all those components they are given. According to that, we have to construct this universal coupling over there. Okay. So whatever value we are not knowing, we could be able to identify from this part drawer. Okay, this is about the universal coupling. Suppose the value it may be exist, they are providing those all those things. Then comes into the split muff coupling. The split muff coupling. So here also the component will be less. Okay, so here almost both the shafts, very minimum gap it will be connected over here. So the distance from the split muff coupling from here to here 36, the outer here 36 mm. Okay, so the top it will be going to connect with the rigidly, and the bottom only with the help of the screws they are going to be connect over there. Okay, so some of the two rigidly fixed screws they are going to connect with the this split muff coupling over here, not in the this one, the side they are going to connect. Okay, like two screws and four it's going to be connected. So this is the 3D model of wall dams coupling. So in the wall dams coupling also, the little bit the height variation it will be takes place for the shafts over there. Okay, so here the diameter for wall dams coupling they are providing over here. Okay, 0.60 and 0.3D. So from this it is going to be construct over here. center some of the column they are provided for support. Okay, so this will be going to give support for both the shaft, and also it will be helps to rigidly fix for the both the shafts. Okay, so for this purpose this wall dams coupling has to be used over here. The distance between from here to here is the 0.5D. So and the gap exists between the center collar and the shaft is the 0.3D. Even here also the gap exists between this shaft and here is the 0.3D. And maximum length of the maximum dia of this wall dams couple is the 3.5D. And supporting to that it will be the 2D. Okay, so like this this values and all we have to remember, we have to construct in the wall dam couple. So this is the part of wall dam couple. This is the left end, this is center collar, right end. So this is the center collar, it can separate the both the shaft in a different manner. Okay, so this is about the wall dams couple. So this three parts we mainly we remember, and we have to supposed to draw over in the 2D manner in the SolidWorks software. So mainly in the keys, coupling on the threads, so those values and all we have to remember. Okay, so here according to the whatever the diameter of the shaft, remaining things we have to design over there, the remaining diameter and other thing. Okay, that is the important thing. So this we have to we might be remember, and we have to draw in the software. So thank you. So with that keys and coupling get over. Okay, so the flanged coupling, so those things I put to I drawn and I explained over in the software. So that will be attached over in the Google Classroom. So with that are going to complete this coupling chapter. Thank you.